Hi Aquarius, welcome back to Omkaratarot and to another You versus Them. Aquarius, let's see how you're feeling now, how the person connected to your energy is feeling, and what action we can expect in this connection. And Aquarius, these are general collective readings, may not resonate with all of you. Please keep that in mind. Take what works for you and leave the rest. So let's begin. Welcome back all my subscribers and welcome in newcomers. Aquarius spirit. Aquarius. All right, newcomers, I'm setting down two sets of cards here. One side will be for you, one side will be for your person. And in the center, I'm going to have your dialogue message cards, mutual energies. If this is your reading, Aquarius, you'll know which side you resonate best with. For me, this is going to be person A, this is going to be person B. Bottom of my deck, chariot in reverse. So there is a blockage between the two of you, Aquarius, even though I see one person is absolutely ready. They want to heal things between the two of you. They want to take action. They are gathering up their courage to come and sweep the other person off their feet, get victory in this connection. They see a happily ever after with the other person. They feel, this is my soulmate. This is my twin flame. We are meant to be together. The other person says, I thought they were going to give me one big offer, but they gave me very little, Omkaratarot. I was waiting, but I am not sure. I think they were just treating me like a friend or a friends with benefits or something. According to them, the person A was probably cheating or lying or ghosting them or running away or something. So person B could be more focused right now, maybe on a brand new beginning for themselves, or stabilizing their own finances, or just moving forward, right? So that's why the blockage is there, because one person is absolutely ready, the other person doesn't know. So they're saying, yeah, I don't think any reconciliation is happening. They haven't come towards me with any big offer or anything like that. So let's ask the universe first, why all this is happening? Why is Aquarius and that person feeling like this or going through this right now, spirit? Aquarius and their person, spirit, what's the deeper meaning for these two to be going through this situation right now? One more. All right. And here it is. So first card is lessons. Remembering what was learned from the past. So maybe you guys had to trigger each other to learn some important lessons, but there is hope. Hopeful, feeling optimistic for the future. And the last card here says, divine timing. Something may not be when you want it, but when you need it. So I have a feeling one person wanted it before. It's like I've been waiting for that offer, but they haven't brought it. So that means they're never going to come back with it, or I don't want it anymore, and maybe it's time for me to move forward. But now I think the other person could be ready. Divine timing. All right. So let's also see, Aquarius, if you guys could say something to each other now, what that would be, and then we'll clarify these. Aquarius and their person, spirit, if they could say something to each other now, what would that be? Aquarius and their person, if they could say something to each other now, spirit. All right, let's take a few more from another deck, Aquarius. Aquarius and their person, spirit, if they could say something to each other now, what would that be? Okay, and a few more, Aquarius, from a third deck as well, and then we'll start the reading. Aquarius and their person, spirit, if they could say something to each other now, what would that be? All right, good to go. Let's start the reading, Aquarius. And if any of you are looking for personal readings, my email is omkaratarot@gmail.com. You can reach me there. It's there in the description box below as well. So the first card here says, you changed up, and that triggers me. Yeah, this connection was meant to trigger the two of you. It's best to part ways. We are not compatible as we used to be. This could be person B saying, yeah, I think it's time for us to part ways now. I feel so alone. Why did you abandon me? Do you really believe I'm the one for you? have anger issues I'm working on. You always knew how to make me smile. Nothing else matters but you. I really do love you. I just don't feel as if I'm good enough for you yet. Our union will happen in divine time. You have to trust that. And I got that same card from the universe as well, divine time, and the dialogue message card says the same thing. So something could be happening at maybe the perfect time. It breaks my heart to know that I broke your pure heart. I'm so embarrassed over my actions. I've been dreaming of you. I know that you're the one for me. All right, so Aquarius, these were some of your messages. If these were resonating with your storyline, let's start this reading. But first, I'm going to take out an angel blessing card. And this card is going to be for the viewer. So Aquarius, you could be watching. Maybe your cross watchers watching today to check on your energy. So my intention is for the viewer of this reading, a blessing, guidance, advice, or a message from the angels. Vision. Instead of focusing on what happened in the past, yes, past lessons that have been learnt must be learnt, but then you have to make sure that you don't repeat them in your future. Right? So this was a triggering connection where you triggered each other to learn something, but now you have to see what you want going forward. Instead of focusing on the past, the mistakes, learn the lessons and focus now what you want for your future. Okay, so Spirit, now tell me what's going on. Let's start with Person A's energy and newcomers. Remember, these are not gender-based and I don't know which side you're on, nor do I want to know. I want to be fair to both these souls who are going to speak to me right now. If this is your reading, you would be one side. The other side would be, the person you're connected to, could be your love interest, spouse, ex, could be your best friend, business partner, could be a relative, who knows. So if this is your reading, you're resonating, you'll figure out immediately who this person is and which side of the equation they're on and which side you're on. For me, this is Person A, who I'm going to focus on right now. I'm going to do the full one side first and later move to the other side so there's no confusion. Okay, so let's start with Person A. So Person A, in your feelings, in your emotions, you have the Temperance card. What's that? Temperance. I have a feeling, whoever Person A is, they were sitting in a little bit of their ego and pride maybe at one time. They probably thought they had all the time in the world. I don't have to open my mouth and reveal my emotions just yet. I think they're realizing they made a mistake, and because of that mistake, they've kind of maybe losing out on a soulmate bond or a soulmate connection. I think this person does want to take action now. King of Wands, yeah, they want to bring back this happiness. They're ready to take action. Not just action, they're ready for commitment. This person says, I'm ready now. I know I emotionally never opened up towards them in the past. I kept secrets from them about how I felt about them or I wanted for the future. I really thought I had enough time and I could pursue my own travels and my businesses and my work and, you know, get attention from other people. And, you know, later on, I mean, I would go towards them. But I feel in doing so, that was silly of me because I'm so embarrassed now. I'm so ashamed of, my own past behavior. But now I'm ready to take action. I'm ready. I want to bring back this happiness. I want this commitment. I'm just praying and wishing and hoping that they give me a chance. I don't want this chapter to be shut down. I want a second chance with them. Why do you feel this way, Person A? Strength card, because maybe now the other person has pulled back. Maybe the other person has pulled back and the other person could have said, like, you know what, if you're going to sit in your ego and your pride and you're never going to offer me anything, then I might as well take my energy back. But the problem here is that now this person actually does want this. They want to offer the Ten of Pentacles. They don't want to have a missed opportunity here. This person doesn't want to grow old and think, I should have. Why didn't I even try? So this person really wants to have victory now. Okay, so they may be sending a message or something to tell the other person that, you know what, don't think I think you think of you as an option. You're the only cup I want. I'm ready now. I'm absolutely ready to take responsibility. I choose you. I've made up my mind. I want to do right by you. So this person is absolutely ready. Right? Person A. How do you see the connection now, and how do you see person B? Ten of Cups, Two of Cups. Person A says, I want a happily ever after with the other persons because I know they are my person. And I made some unwise and foolish choices in the past, and I never told my person that I loved them or I didn't offer anything because I always thought sooner or later I'll return. I'll return when the time is right. But the fear is that the other person who they now realize they love so much may have pulled back their love, right? And they are not sure whether they can have victory, or maybe they're a little embarrassed and ashamed of their past behavior. But heart of hearts, they know that this is my Ten of Cups and this is my Two of Cups. This is the person I want to return back to. And I think they want to do it now because they feel they've already wasted too much time. They've already wasted too much time. They took too long. Maybe this person was in their little toxic behavior at the in the past. They could have been the runner maybe in this connection. So now they are wanting to come back, probably because they see the other person is maybe single and attracting a lot of attention or doing very, very well on their own. They don't want to miss out on having this brand new beginning with the other person. They want to make wrongs right. It's like I have to make a move now, hoping that the chapter is still open so that I can quickly go back in and offer them this commitment. So they could be a little bit spying as well. They could be looking at social media, asking friends, asking family that are they still waiting? Have they moved on? But on their own, I think they're getting a little impatient now because they have so much passion for the other person. They want to rush towards the other person. I think they're going through a tower right now, realizing how much they want it. It's like they're going through the tower, realizing, I do want this partnership and I want it now. There is, I think, a deep fear. There is a deep fear that somebody else may take action before them and they'll get left out in the cold. Okay, so what action they will finally take is here, which I'll open later, Aquarius. Let's go to the other side and see how person B is feeling, and then we'll do the action cards. So person B, tell me, what in your feelings, in your emotions, in your thoughts, you have the Ace of Pentacles. Oh, same thing. A person A says, you read that right, Omkaratarot. I was expecting a big, stable offer from them. They came to me with a pages amount of offer, which was almost a no offer. How can this be my soulmate? This is a false soulmate. If this was a true soulmate, they would have invested, right? They could have messaged me, they could have talked to me, they could have put in some work, they could have traveled towards me, they could have done a lot of things. But all they did was push me away, push me away, push me away till, things started becoming really troublesome and things were going backwards instead of going forward. And I don't want to waste any more time. I don't want to waste any more time, energy, effort on a person who's never going to make up their mind or is always going to push me away, is not ready for commitment, doesn't see the value of this connection, doesn't want a happily ever after. I don't think I want to give this a second chance, Omkaratarot. In fact, I'm thinking that I should just get unstuck from the situation now. I've healed. I've been healing from all the pain that they've caused me. The sleepless nights, the stress, the tension, the nightmares I've gone through, and the stagnancy of this connection. So tell me more, person B, why are you feeling this way that, it's over or they didn't give you anything? Hermit. Person B says, because all they created was drama, conflict. Making me fight for their attention, keeping secrets from me, getting me emotional, treating me like a friend or friends with benefits. It was a very, very hard time, Omkaratarot. But I really tried. I really did try for a long, long time till I got exhausted, I got tired, and I felt I'm the only one who's keeping myself stuck here, and I cut those chains off. And I realized, you know, what am I waiting for an offer from them? Let me just move forward and find the stability on my own or from myself. No longer waiting to reconcile with them so they can offer me something. Yeah, so I think person B is now kind of mirroring person A to say, you know what, I don't want to give this a second chance. Now I'm blocking them away. I don't want to waste my time. So, yeah. So person B, tell me, how do you see the connection now? How do you see person A and how do you feel about this connection? Person B says, person A, they were a liar, they were a cheater, they ghosted me and they did it over and over again. They were very, very petty and I've kind of lost hope in this connection, Omkaratarot. I mean, they should have at least come and offered me an apology. A small love offer, if not that, at least an apology. But they didn't. They just ran. They just ran and left me here sitting under a tree, feeling discontent, sad, lonely. I should have been looking at my other options, which I didn't because I was so sad over them. Now I'm kind of changing my mind. I'm saying, you know what? I'm going to take a leap of faith in a new direction. I'm ready for something new, universe. I'm ready to take a risk on something brand new. What's the Fool card? Tell me, what's the Fool card? Yeah, person B says, I'm getting unstuck from this. I'm healing myself now. I'm working on my own pentacle. I'm no longer stressed out. I am totally moving forward. Why? Because I think person B says, every time there was any question of commitment or long-term or taking responsibility, this person, they just pushed me away and they never made up their mind. So, well, let's see what actions you guys will take then. I'm going to take another deck for this one, Aquarius. And while I shuffle these cards, may I please request you now, remind you, if you could just tap the like button for me, please. Helps the videos to circulate, keeps me motivated to do more Aquarius readings for you and newcomers, repeating viewers. Do like, share, subscribe to the channel. It's absolutely free for you to do so. We welcome you in. All right, so person A, action from your end towards person B or otherwise. Knight of Swords. I told you they want to rush back in. Why do you want to rush back in? Tell me. They want to offer that Ace of Pentacles. Oh, wow. That same Ace of Pentacles that person B has been waiting for so long, which they say they never offered me. They offered me very little. They say, no, wait. Don't go away. I'm coming with it. I want to offer it to you. Okay. Clarify the Knight of Swords, person A. Some more clarification, please, for the Knight of Swords. They want a second chance. They're rushing back in because they want to offer something stable. Yeah, they want to take action. They want to take action. They want a second chance. They're looking into their future and they want to heal person B's broken heart now. They want person B in their life. This person is going through a lot of stress and anxiety with just the thought that if they don't rush in now, they're going to lose person B. Their person B is going to emotionally walk away from them and then it may be too late and there'll be other competition and then by that time person B will change their mind and say, I'm sorry, you were late. I've already shut the door now. And then their offer will not get accepted. Right? So I think they're holding on very tight to the fact that let me go now, let me rush in now before I lose my person completely. So person B, what about you? Action from your end towards person A or otherwise? Emperor. What's the Emperor? Are you taking back control of your own life or are you waiting for person A to? Let's see. No. Person B says, I had a vision in my mind, Omkaratarot. I had a vision of the type of person I wanted to spend the rest of my life with. I want somebody to be responsible, to, you know, be my perfect partner, to do right by me. And yes, I did think it was going to be person A, but if it's not them, then I'm not going to compromise. I'm going to look for somebody new who can fit the bill. Yep, even if it's taking a leap of faith in a new direction. So person B says, I want the kind of partner I want. And if they can't be that, then I'm going to go on and find somebody new who fits into that photo frame that they have, I think, in their mind. So That's what I have for you then, Aquarius. Till next time then, love and light. Take care. Namaste.